drivers have loved to have been able to walk in the streets and go to museums, go to theater, go to cinema, concerts, meet people, sit in a coffee shop, have a coffee, take my newspaper and read it in a coffee shop, and just watch people go by. But under the circumstances, that's not what I can do.
It's life of a rat. You go from one hole to another hole.
It's not a life that I would recommend to anyone. It is, one has to be really prepared for it after years. And human beings adapt themselves to different situations. And in particular in my life, if you believe in what you're doing, and if you see the end of the tunnel, which I see it, then you put up with it. But it is not natural and it's not human.
We receive information from inside the country about terrorists who are coming against our organization or myself. We received this picture. I saw the person myself, not far from my house, from the window. My guards went after him. They ran after him, and he was running, and they lost him in the streets of Paris. And the second person is an individual in charge of the terrorist operations of the regime in Europe. And the third picture is a picture we just received 3 days ago by fax. His name is Hassan Hojati, age 55 to 60. It is not clear whether he is going to act himself or whether he's going to have others to carry out the act of assassination. The report says that they are after me personally.
Recule un peu la tête, mettez la tête légèrement plus en arrière. Légèrement en arrière, comme ça. Légèrement, voilà. Voilà. Stabilité du bras avec le coude sur le genou.
Oui, certain.
Comme ça, vous ne bougez plus.
Compris.
Et ça va vite en plus, hein. Vous mettez debout.
Voilà, super.
These people were assassinated by people, terrorists that the regime sent to various European cities within the past 15 years. Sirou Salahi was assassinated in Paris. One morning about 9 o'clock when he was leaving his home in Montparnasse. He was a professor of political science. He had never touched an arm in his life. He believed in political struggle, not armed struggle. Another of our colleagues is Farrokhzad. He was an artist. He was preparing a radio program for us, that's all. And all he did was to participate in concerts and sing for Iranians. Another is Colonel Bay Ahmadi. He was a colonel, former colonel of the Iranian armed forces, who was involved with us in political movement and struggle. And another one is Abbas Ghulizadeh, who was taken as a hostage in Istanbul. It's 4 years ago. And he was held, tortured to get information from, and finally he was killed and his body was found in Turkey. They come from our cells, which are scattered all over, and they have infiltrated inside the regime as high up as the High Council of Security of State and the offices of Mr. Khamenei and the rest of them. So what they do is not really a secret for us. On the assassination of Dr. Bakhtiar, about that time we received information about 8-9 days before about number of assassins coming to France. And we were informed that they had as their targets Dr. Bakhtiar, Prince Reza Pahlavi, Mr. Bani Sadr, or myself. In addition to passing it to the authorities, I took the liberty of telephoning Prince Reza, who was in south of France at that time, Mr. Bani Sadr, who was in Paris, and I telephoned Dr. Bakhtiar. Unfortunately, he was in a meeting. I talked with Mr. Katibe, his secretary, who unfortunately was assassinated with him.
Il était comment de contact?
Assez sympathique. C'était dans une soirée et puis je le connaissais par sa cousine. Et il m'a demandé, il savait que, qui j'étais. Donc il m'a demandé est-ce que docteur est bien à Paris, est-ce qu'il est en France.
Il cherchait des renseignements sur le docteur Ganji.
Oui. À chaque fois, il me disait est-ce que docteur est à Paris. Alors moi, je disais non, je ne sais pas et tout, s'il est à Paris ou non, je ne le vois pas. Comment je peux savoir s'il est à Paris?
Et vous avez eu l'impression que il essayait d'avoir des renseignements de façon à ce que, si c'est pas à tuer Bakhtiar, il essaye de tuer le docteur Ganji?
Il pensait que, à mon avis, hein, il pensait que c'est un danger pour le régime, en fait. Parce qu'il bouge beaucoup, il est vraiment...
Très actif?
Oui, très actif.
Et donc il fallait le supprimer, quoi.
Oui, voilà, ce que j'ai pensé.
Qu'est-ce qui s'est passé dans votre tête quand vous avez appris, après, qu'il était un des trois assassins de Bakhtiar?
Ça m'a choqué. Vraiment, j'ai eu le choc énorme. Parce que j'ai pensé pas du tout qu'il puisse tuer Bakhtiar, parce qu'il me disait qu'il adorait Bakhtiar. C'est ça plutôt qui m'a choqué. Je le voyais pas du tout, c'est ça.
Et maintenant que vous êtes assuré,
oui.
Maintenant là, c'est bon là. Vous pouvez prendre la corde ici.
Qu'est-ce qu'il fait?
Les jambes tendues. Voilà. Les fesses dans le vide. Voilà, très bien.
Je vous tiens, hein.
Voilà, très bien. C'est fini là.
Voilà.
Là vous allez. Tranquille, c'est fini.
Voilà, c'est bon, c'est
ça. Allez. Ah ouais, c'est bon là. Allez, par contre, c'est bon, tranquille. Allez, vite. Voilà. Lâchez là la corde à la main droite un peu. Bravo. C'est pas bon.
بیشتر از راجب الجزیره سوال کرد ازش.
آره در پشت بکنی یه ذره خونه کشم اونجا خیلی گرم. آره در
هم
بیشتر تمام این هم این کنفرانس کرام مونتانا و تمام این چیزا که آقای دوما بشینه و آقا رو بیارن روی چیز ساتلیت و فلان بکنن، بعد به قد احترام بهش بذارن کنن کنن اینه که اون یه همچین جمعه ای رو بگه و اینه از این جمعه استفاده کنن.
ولی خودش از با پسگرایی اسلامی هم دفاع کرده اولش
گفته خودم اصلا اونها رو بذار کنار میگه friends, Romans, countrymen
چی میگه؟ میگه که دروغ رو تا چقدر میشه چیز کرد ما دختر زمان علم هستیم و با این چیزها اصلا
Now you see our gross domestic product today is 10% less than what it was 15 years ago. Our population today is about 80% more than what it used to be 15 years ago. Our per capita income is far less today than what it was 15 years ago. The rate of unemployment, the inflation which is galloping every day. Dollar used to be 70 rial 15 years ago. Today it's 2,900 rial to 3,000 rial, which is about over 42 times more. The inflation on average is something like 24 to 25 times what it, the prices of consumer items, generally speaking, is 24, 25 times more than what it was 15 years ago, whereas the wages and salaries have not increased by more than 3 to 4 times. You have a population of 73% below the age of 30. And you have a population of about nearly 50% below the age of 20. Our schools are 3 to 4 shift schools. That means children don't go to school more than a day and a half each week. So where is Iran heading?
هموطنان خارج از ایران هموطنان خارج از ایران شمایی که از جور و بیداد این رژیم تبهکار منحوس ملایان به ناچار به سرزمین های بیگانه رفته اید این سیمای درفش کاویانی است
بگو یارب بگو یارب چه بد گفتم چه بد کردم
Acts of torture, discrimination against women, the practices of cutting hand and cutting feet and throwing a person from the summit of a mountain and stoning a woman, the law of retribution, eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, the executions. During the past 15 years, minimum number is 50,000 to 100,000. Some figures give 100,000 executions inside Iran. Minimum is 50,000. Those are executions by so-called Islamic kangaroo court orders. That's Islamic revolutionary courts. But there are individuals who have disappeared in Iran. No one knows who where they are. There are many of them.
چشم وقت پایین نخواهد خوبه؟ به اصول بشر دوستی و احترام به حقوق و آزادی های فردی و خلاصه از همه میراث فرهنگی غنی کشورمون کمک میگیرد با بهره‌جویی از فرهنگ غنی کشورمون کوشیده اید تا عدم مشروعیت رژیم آخوندی را هر روز بیش از پیش برملا کنید
No one can name himself as the Grand Ayatollah. And in our religion, there is no one who can name himself as the supreme religious guide and say that he is the representative of God on earth. So what they are doing is contrary to our religion.
le guide pratique du combattant. Ça explique un peu tout. Deux cigarettes qui vont couper la file, qui vont faire partir les tracts sur la ville. Il y a le stencil qui est expliqué comment le faire avec le cadre, les vis, le papier où ça se met, le scotch.
Example of the such help that we receive. It is token contribution, it is little, it's not much, but it is for morale and for the feeling that you have your countrymen who are providing assistance, it means a lot. It means a great deal. Whenever there is a 1,500 real bill, or 1,000 real, or 5,000 real, or 200 real bill, which is not much, which is very little. It is only about a franc and a half, but it boosts your morale a great deal when you open the envelope and you see that they are offering you. Who is sending that? Is a young man of 14, 15 years old or 16 years old who was born since the revolution has taken place. It's a token of his appreciation and a token of his recognition for what you are doing. It boosts your morale.
فرمانده های خودشون بگن به سوی مردمی که حق خودشون رو میخوان و به تبعیض، ناعدالتی، گرانی اعتراض دارن هرگز شلیک نخواهند کرد.
یا در یک جابجایی در اتوبوس و تاکسی و یا اماکن عمومی اون دست نوشته ها رو عمدن جا میذارن که هموطن دیگه از اونها استفاده کنه.
Chaque semaine, nous recevons des lettres, des coups de téléphone, des intérieurs. Vous savez, envoyer des lettres maintenant, c'est très très cher. Et c'est très dangereux de téléphoner extérieur. Malgré tout ça, toujours nous avons des coups de fil d'Iran.
Struggle is a political struggle. We are not involved in armed opposition to the regime. And today, the new technology such as fax, television, radio, cable, provides means that didn't exist before. So it has taken the place of samizdat. We have today in Iran, there are altogether, from what we know, more than 20,000-25,000 fax machines, maybe even more. We have some 5,000 fax numbers. So we have the telephone numbers of all the ministers, the ministers and police stations universities, schools, and others, the pastors. So we have our texts, like the one I'm just sending to Rafsanjani's office, which we send continuously. We inform the people about what's going on inside the country, what their rights are, and why they should stand up and demand that their rights be respected. And we teach them about civil disobedience, we teach them about what is freedom of information, and that they have to take their destiny into their own hands. So this is one number that I will just dial, and you will see. We send the fax to the office of the so-called president of the regime. (19) 9821, and the number, one of the fax numbers of the office is 646-0156. This fax, we are telling them that don't you think after 15 years of destruction of the country, you have destroyed the economy of the country, you have violated the rights and freedoms of the people to the extent that it's the talk of the town everywhere in the world. And that goes now by itself. It's going to the office. Don't you think it's about time for you to learn from history of Eastern European countries, of what happened in Nicaragua, what happened in Chile, and what happened in South Africa, and do the same, and accept that people express themselves. And in an open, supervised, internationally supervised election and a referendum. It's as simple as that. In a matter of 20 seconds, 15 seconds, you send your message to. So dictatorships cannot prevail as they did before.
I'm separated from my wife and my children, so it is a difficult time. But my wife, had it not been for her understanding and her support, I wouldn't have been able to do what I'm doing. I don't regret. I think under the circumstances, if I had been given the chance, I would have done exactly the same. Under the circumstances. That means if there had been a terrorist regime like there is in Iran, and there was a chance of liberating Iran and making Iran free, to be, make oneself to be proud of one's nationality and not to be treated as a terrorist when you are seen by people as soon as you utter the word you come from Iran, I would have chosen exactly the same.
First of all, I don't consider them to be in any position to order that someone should be killed. Who are they to do that? I know inside Iran they have the state machinery in their hand and they are killing people left and right. But I don't recognize any such fatwa. And besides, I'm not afraid of dying. I know I was born one day and I must die one day. So they will do me an honor. If they do that, the whole world will know that they have acted again. And this is another act of assassination. I would rather die fighting for what I believe, which is a noble cause, and it is cause of human rights and freedom of my country, than die of a disease and natural death. So I think by assassinating me, they are not removing a force that they would have to be, they would face with for a long period of time to come in case they exist. But there will be thousands who will take my place. There will be others. That this is the problem with dictatorship. Dictators think that by killing one person, they can remove the cause, whereas they don't know that the cause will always prevail.